Since the Bududa tragedy on the 11th of this month, government launched a massive search for missing bodies after an estimated 400 people went missing. By yesterday, the number of recovered bodies had increased from 47 to 60. Government plans to end the search this week, even though there are fears that some bodies are still trapped in debris that covered homes.
Long since it happened on the 11th. This is a number of days so far. And all the rescue teams, they have been on the ground. They have done their best. We believe so far what they did is good enough. And you know, some decomposing bodies, when they reach a certain point, when you go on with exhuming, sometimes you also create some other issues, unless you have a specialist team doing it.
Speaking during a one-day symposium on financing, disaster preparedness, mitigation, and preparation in Uganda, the Commissioner for Disaster Preparedness, Martin Owor, worryingly noted that Bududa is likely to continue being hit by mudslides in the coming years. He expressed frustration that government has failed to build resilience towards financing disaster preparedness.
Give us tents, give us tarpaulins, give us food, give us blankets, give us mosquito nets. We shall move by the month of May and stay there up to the month of August when the risk has reduced and then go back to our homes. Do I get money to give, buy these tents and give to these people and mosquito nets? I don't. That's where the challenge is.
Some members of parliament are now considering to push for the private members' bill to make amendments in the Red Cross Act so that Red Cross is empowered with more finances to take on the full responsibility of disaster preparedness away from the office of the Prime Minister.
This law only deserves to be repealed and replaced with a comprehensive law that can reflect the challenges of today. And that is what we are ready for, and that is what we are planning. OPM should be mandated on policy, monitoring that policy is being implemented, and that is it. But to run around with the push on their backs, I think it is embarrassing enough.
They also want international experts to be brought on board to help establish the root cause of continuous mudslides in Bududa.